and welcome to this video on our How My Computer Works series. In this video, I want to show you some of the ways you can help restore your internet connection if it becomes lost or slow. Now, the first thing you'll want to do with this and most other computer problems is to reboot your computer. This will reset the operating system's part of the internet connection. As a side note, if it's just one particular website you're having trouble accessing, you can go to this website, downforeveryoneorjustme.com. Plug in the address of the website you're trying to connect to, and it will tell you if the website is having issues or if the problem is on your end. Anyway, if rebooting the computer doesn't solve the problem, you'll want to look at your cable modem or DSL modem. It should have a series of lights on it, like this one. On a cable modem, the lights will typically be labeled power, receive, send, online, activity, and standby. Usually, the first four lights should be on and the activity light should be blinking sporadically. If this is not the case, you'll want to check your connections from the wall outlet to the modem, to your router, if you have one, to your computer. Now, if the standby light is on, that may be your problem right there. You may have accidentally pressed the standby button on the top of the modem, which would suspend your internet connection until it is pressed again. If all lights look normal, you can proceed to power cycling the cable modem, router, and computer. Basically, what this means is turning these components off and then back on again. On the modem and router, simply disconnect the power from both. Then shut down your computer. Give it about 20 to 30 seconds, then reconnect the power to the modem. Wait about 30 seconds for all the lights to come on. Then reconnect the power to the router and turn on your computer. Give your computer a few minutes to completely start up, then try connecting to the internet. If you're still having a problem, call your internet service provider, such as Cox, Comcast, Quest, etc., as there may be an outage or problem in your area. They can also run some diagnostic tests on your modem to make sure it is working properly. If you're calling because of slow internet speeds, visit speedtest.net before you call. This test will tell you the exact internet speeds you're getting and find out if your internet speeds are actually slow. If all is clear on the provider's end, you can call My Computer Works or another qualified computer technician for help. Finally, a word about wireless routers. Although wireless connectivity has been around for a number of years, it can still prove to be flaky or unreliable. I would recommend connecting your computer to your router through a wired connection with one of these. It's called an Ethernet cable, or Cat5 cable, and it looks like an oversized telephone cable. However, if your computer is not located close to your router and you choose to use wireless connectivity, make sure to place your router as high as you can, such as on a bookshelf, and keep it as far away as possible from interference items like televisions, cell phones, refrigerators, and microwaves. As always, if you have any questions about this particular video, or if you have any training suggestions or comments, go ahead and send me an email at training@mycomputerworks.com. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button above any one of our YouTube videos. You can also find us on Facebook and Twitter by clicking either of the links in the More Info section just under this video. If you have any questions about My Computer Works or would like to know more information about our services, go ahead and call the number you see below or visit us online at mycomputerworks.com. My name is Matt Bauer. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.